اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد النبي الأمي.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله وكفى، والصلاة والسلام على عباده الذين اصطفى، ولا سيما سيدنا محمدا صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وسلم المصطفى، وعلى آله أهل الوفاء وأصحابه أهل الصفاء، وعلى من بآثارهم اقتفى واهتدى. أما بعد، we'll start the 40 Nawawi hadith inshaAllah ta'ala. I assume you all have the book with you inshaAllah ta'ala. So we'll start with the first hadith and the whole Arba'een. I narrate them with a continuous sanad through our Shaykh Muhammad Abdul Razzaq al-Khatib bi-isnadihi an al-Shaykh Abi Nasr al-Khatib بإسناده عن الشيخ التلي بإسناده عن الشيخ عبد الغني النابلسي رحمه الله تعالى and بإسناده عن البدر عفوا النجم الغزي بإسناده عن البدر الغزي that's his father رحمه الله تعالى and with that سند obviously then we go to الإمام ابن حجر رحمه الله تعالى وفرم ابن حجر لأبي إسحاق التنوخي and from أبي إسحاق to Ali al-Attar, and from Ali al-Attar we go to Imam al-Nawawi, and that's probably the shortest available. لكن I narrated with a continuous Sama'i Sanad, which is continuously with the Shafi'i Sadat, رحمهم الله تعالى ورضي عنهم, through our Shaykh Qasim al-Washali, رحمه حفظه الله تعالى, through Muhammad bin Yahya al-Ahdal, through the Ahdal narrations all the way. And this is a sama'i, which means a continuous auditory sanad. It's not only ijaza, because the Shafi'is, as you know, they glorify Imam al-Nawawi, so that Imam al-Nawawi is Shafi, and that's part of the tradition. So that's one of them. I also narrated through many of my shuyukh, many of them obviously through my father first and foremost, and many of them through such as Abdul Rahman al-Kittani, through his father, Sheikh Abdul Hayy, hafizahullah, or rahimahullah ta'ala, through Abdul Ghani al-Dahlawi, through his father, Ahmad, through then both of them, to Abu Ishaq, through obviously Abdul Shah Abdul Aziz, through Shah Abdul Hayy, through Shah Abdul Ahmad waliullah, عبد الرحيم ولي الله الدهلوي through عبد الرحمن نخلي through his father أحمد and through الديري etc. with the known isnad then from that on to الإمام النووي and that's a known isnad as well. قال الإمام وبهذا يعني وبأسانيدكم إلى الإمام النووي رحمه الله تعالى إن شاء الله قال عن أمير المؤمنين أبي حفص عمر بن الخطاب رضي الله تعالى عنه قال obviously, this hadith is, he says, Amir al-Mu'mineen. Amir al-Mu'mineen, obviously, the commander of the believers. Umar ibn al-Khattab, why do we call him Abu Hafs? Why is, what does Hafs mean? Who knows what Hafs means? Lion. Hafs means lion. So Abu Hafs is like the father of lion, or like the one who is stronger than lions. And that's the kunya, or that's the nickname of Sayyidina Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu warda. قال عن سيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه وارضى قال سمعت رسول الله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم يقول إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله فهجرته إلى الله ورسوله ومن كانت هجرته لدنيا يصيبها أو امرأة ينكحها فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. And I don't have, the translation is there, but let me quickly translate it. Sayyidina Umar radiallahu anhu said, I heard Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam say, Al-A'mal is by the deed, by the niyyah, by the intentions. Deeds are by intentions. And every human being, to every human being is what they have intended. Whomever is migration to Allah and His Prophet, then their migration is to Allah and His Prophet. And whoever's migration is for a piece of the worldly interest to get, or a woman to marry, then their migration is for what they have migrated for. This hadith obviously is among the most important hadith. You will see there that Sayyidina يعني الإمام النووي رحمه الله puts it as number one. Also, الإمام النووي did not put this hadith as number one hadith in this book only, but put it also in his book Riyadu Salihin and put it in other books as well as the first hadith. Also, if you notice, الإمام البخاري رحمه الله way before النووي put this hadith as the first hadith in his book to indicate its importance, that this deen is about diniyah. Also, يعني أبو داود رحمه الله تعالى, you all know Imam Abu Dawood, he said that this hadith is nisful Islam. Half of Islam is this hadith. And many of the ulama said that يعني this hadith is the third of Islam, etc. So you see that. Because Al-Islam is two things. Thing, عمل بالجوارح, يعني work, deeds with the limbs and deeds with the heart. This niyya, الأعمال بالنيات, the intention is the deed of the heart. And that's one of the most important things then in our deen. خير. الهجرة here, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم says, إنما الأعمال بالنيات وإنما لكل امرئ ما نوى. The deeds have to have niyya. The niyya or the intention is like the soul of the deed. The deed is a body and the niyya is the soul. Bodies don't live without soul. And therefore, deeds without niyya, no deeds, right? And therefore, you see in the siyam right now, the intention on the niyyah, you do the niyyah what? Before. Everything you do the niyyah before you start a deed, or at the starting of the deed, obviously. You have a deed without niyyah becomes a problem. Niyyah without deed is rewarded. You have a niyyah to do a good deed. You don't do it, you're rewarded. You have a deed without niyyah, you don't do niyyah. Deed is questionable. الحديث, reason for this hadith came, يعني maybe Imam Nawawi did not put it here, لكن the reason for this hadith is what Imam al-Tabarani narrated in his Mu'jam with an authentic sanad, رجاله ثقات, يعني trustworthy sanad, that a man, Ibn Mas'ud says, one man from Mecca wanted to marry a woman, her name was Umm Qais. But Umm Qais says, I'll only marry you if you migrate. هذا حديث صحيح, huh? So the man migrated to marry Umm Qais. So they called him Muhajir Umm Qais. The migrant for Umm Qais. يعني he did not migrate for Allah and his Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but he migrated for a woman. Huh? And therefore Ibn Mas'ud used to say also on another hadith where Sa'id Mansur in his Sunan with also an authentic sanad mentioned that don't be like the man who migrated for a woman, so we called him the Muhajir of Umm Qais. In other words, make sure that your niyas are pure for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for his Prophet sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam in that sense for the niyah. Obviously, as you know, in the essential a'mal, the niyah is fard, salah, siyam, hajj, zakah, all these things. لكن in the wasail, the fuqaha differed and disagreed. Al-Hanafiyya radiallahu anhum, يعني the Hanafi ulama, they say هذا من تكامل العمل, يعني كمال العمل, so that you have your amal complete, then you have your niyyah. لكن عند الشافعية فرض. يعني الوضوء وسيلة للصلاة. الوضوء, for example, is a way for salah. Without niyyah of wudu, then you have all these things, then are off. يقوله صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم, فمن كانت هجرته إلى الله ورسوله. يعني we take from this also the wujub of hijra. Hijra is what? What is hijra? To migrate. To migrate what? Before you migrate your body, you migrate your soul. You migrate your soul from things that Allah does not like to things that Allah like. يعني so that Allah does not see you where He doesn't want you and sees you where He wants you. هجرة. نعم. لكن الصحابة, for the صحابة رضي الله عنهم, the migration was from مكة to Medina. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى. The last thing I'd like to mention here, يقول قوله صلى الله عليه وسلم at the end of the hadith, فهجرته إلى ما هاجر إليه. Two things. Number one, that we should have إخلاص in our عبادات. القرآن والإسلام wants you to direct your heart. لأنه first of all, the heart is important for the عبادة. Not just the ritual. The ibadah, I always say, is not ritual, it's spiritual. And if you have the heart involved at the beginning, then there is spiritual involved, not only ritual. And therefore, ritual without spiritual becomes a problem. Aniyyah is the amal qalbi, an action of the heart. And therefore, you're already working the heart at the beginning of the deed. Huh? Ya Allah, I'm intending to do this for you. Lakin if there is no niyyah, your heart is ghafil. Your heart is absent, and by definition, then there will be what? Your limbs will be absent. You may be doing the rituals, lakin you're not there. So notice the calibration. The hadith is important in that sense. The other thing that I'll finish with, I know the time is coming. Aniyyah makes your deeds, your casual deeds, rewarding. Rewarded, what does that mean? You're going to go eat now. Yeah? Very nice. I know. Everyone is hungry, alhamdulillah. Lakin when you make that niyyah, you eat for the sake that Allah gives you the power to worship Him. That niyyah. Not only you eat so because you're hungry. I understand. Lakin make the niyyah that you eat so Allah empowers you to worship Him better. Then eating the food becomes an act of worship in the sense that you are making money on that. Making reward. My uncle, rahmatullahi alayh, Sheikh Sayyid Saeed used to always say before he starts, I'm not telling you this is a bid'ah, so you make it, no. Make your own niyyah, whatever it is. Like, I'm just giving an example. Ala niyyat, before he starts, he said, ala niyyat al-shifa, on a niyyah of being cured, wa radd al-bala, and we have no diseases or hardships, wa nasri ala al-a'da, you all know this one, littaqawwi ala ta'atillah, so we can have quwwah on the ta'a of Allah. With this, inshallah, then your food will be rewarding. And we finish with this. Sallallahu ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala.
Umar said, fa'ajibna lahu yas'aluhu wa yusaddiquhu. Yani we were amazed at him asking him, then saying, you are saying the truth. When you ask, you don't know the answer.
Absent-minded.
الآخر وتؤمن بالقدر خيره وشره. The six things in Iman. Believe in Allah, His Malaika, His books, His Rusul, the Day of Judgment, and you believe in Allah's decree. قال صدقت. He told him, you've spoken rightly. You've said the truth. Now, Sayyidina Umar does not say we are amazed anymore. They were amazed the first time. Huh? Now they're observing what's going on here. قال فأخبرني عن الإحسان. He told him, tell me about إحسان. قال يعني النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم said أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه فإن لم تكن تراه فإنه يراك. إحسان is that you worship Allah as if you are seeing Him. If you are not seeing Him, He certainly sees you. أي مقام المراقبة. الإحسان is that you worship Allah as if you are seeing everything else. Seeing who? Him. Not your deed, not anything else. Seeing Him. If you are not seeing Him, He certainly sees you. أن تعبد الله كأنك تراه. أي مولانا عنان. فإن لم تكن
مقام
عالي. فإن لم تكن ترى. أي. وفإن لم تكن عندئذ ترى. ها؟ فإن لم تكن. ما دمت كائنا لن ترى. يعني ما دمت ترى نفسك كيف ترى؟ فإن لم تكن ترى. وعلى كل حال هو يرى. نعم. طيب. قال فأخبرني عن الساعة. Tell me about the day of judgment. قال ما المسؤول عنها بأعلم من السائل. بأعلم من السائل. The one who you're asking does not know more than the one that is asking. لا إله إلا الله. لا إله إلا الله. قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها. Tell me about its signs. قال أن تلد الأمة. It says الأم. الأمة ربتها. وأن ترى الحفاة العراة العالة رعاء الشاء يتطاولون في البنيان. ثم انطلق. And the translation of this, he says, you would see that what are the signs? He said, it is when the slave girl would give birth to her, will give birth to her mistress, that you will see the birth. Wait. No, forget that. Slave girl gives birth to her master. Not mistress. This is a mistake, huh? Anybody who has that? When the slave girl gives birth to her master, and then when you see the barefooted, naked, يعني semi-naked, huh? شوف, النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم from that time is telling us, huh? كاسيات عاريات. Huh? You've heard that hadith? كاسيات عاريات. Clothed but unclothed. Allahu Akbar. You, how can you come up with this? Allah knows. It's ينطق عن الهواء إن هو إلا وحي يوحى. There's no other way. Clothed but not clothed. Do you see that today? لا إله إلا الله. Clothed but not clothed. There's no other way you can put it. يا سلام. شوف نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. Now, slave girl gives birth to its to her masters, and then the barefoot, the naked, or so destitutes, herdsmen competing in constructing high buildings. يتطاولون في البنيان. تطاول, that means, that doesn't mean lofty, يعني luxury. No, تطاول, high. High buildings. I'm sure you've seen them. He said, then he took off. يعني سيدنا عمر now was saying, that man took off, left. He left. نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, عمر says, قال فلبثت مليا. And I stayed a little bit. ثم قال نبي صلى الله عليه وسلم told, يا عمر أتدري من السائل؟ Oh عمر, do you know who was asking? شوف سيدنا عمر رضي الله عنه. He doesn't go and speculate. Nowadays you ask people one question, they give you 15 answers. سيدنا عمر said, الله ورسوله أعلم. بس كده. الله ورسوله أعلم. He didn't say, I think he looks like... Nowadays, because you have to say something. You cannot say, I don't know. No, I don't know. Became a shame in nowadays era of I know everything. We live in an era where I know everything and I have an answer for everything. That's the era. La ilaha illallah. As it became a shame to say, I don't know. Imam Malik ibn Anas, radiallahu anhu. يعني إمام دار الهجرة, one of the four أئمة. The man came to him all the way from Africa, traveling months until he got to him. He had 40 questions from the tribes in Africa. So he got to Malik from Medina. He says, question number one, what do you say about this? Malik says, I don't know. Question number two, what do you say about this? I don't know. 40 questions, 36 of them, I don't know. He says, Ya Imam, you want me to go back to my people? They paid money and all this so I can come with only four answers? What do I tell them? Malik tell them, go tell them. Malik said he doesn't know. Boy. Now imagine. هذه علامات يوم القيامة, by the way. This is the signs of the Day of Judgment. رفع العلم. يتكلم الرويبضة في حديث أحمد في المسند, حديث صحيح إسناده صحيح. يتكلم الرويبضة أو ينطق الرويبضة. قالوا ما الرويبضة يا رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم؟ قال السفيه يتكلم في أمر العامة. سفيه, يعني he learned a couple of words, he thinks he knows. نعم, صلى الله عليه وسلم. قال يا عمر أتدري من السائل؟ Do you know the one who was asking me questions, يا عمر؟ قلت الله ورسوله أعلم. Allah knows best and his رسول knows best. قال فإنه جبريل. He is جبريل. أتاكم يعلمكم دينكم. دينكم. يعلمكم دينكم. جبريل came to teach you your deen. First, هذا الحديث حديث مشهور معروف متواتر, يعني not only صحيح, الإمام مسلم narrated it as they put it here, لكنه حديث متواتر رواه أكثر من ثمانية أو حوالي, I shouldn't say more, 8 صحابة narrated it, أبو ذر وعامر الأشعري وأنس etc. وعمر رضي الله عنه. حديث is narrated by 8 people, considered by the علماء of حديث to be متواتر إن شاء الله, if you lean to 8 being متواتر, if you're not at 10 or more, and there is mutawatir at less, so depending what you like. وهذا الحديث, what do we call أم الكتاب? What is أم الكتاب? الفاتحة, right? Or أم الكتاب, عفوا, أم القرآن. أم الكتاب اللوح المحفوظ. لكن أم القرآن is the فاتحة, they say. And this is حديث is أم الحديث, أو أم السنة. The ulama call this hadith Ummu Sunnah, the mother of the Sunnah. As if the whole sunnah, this is the mother. Just like the Fatiha, for example, is the mother of the Quran or so. This hadith also, the reason it's called Ummu Sunnah is because it has the whole deen. It's the whole deen. Our deen is not only Islam. Our deen is Islam and Iman and Ihsan. يعني الإحسان, the spiritual dimension of that deen. Not only that you say أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله, but إيمان, you believe in لا إله إلا الله, but not only that, you go to إحسان, you observe لا إله إلا الله. You observe لا إله إلا الله. And otherwise becomes lip service only. Observe إحسان, you worship Allah as if you are seeing him. نعم. Another words, يعني, we all agree on the Islam and Iman here, but there is that drop of the Ihsan aspect. While Al-Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, makes it all its deen, your deen. Jibreel came to teach you your deen. So the deen is not only Islam and Iman, the deen is also Ihsan. Al-Islam wal-Iman teach you Iqamat al-Salah, teach you how to make your Salah valid. To make your Salah valid, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 you have to do. You do that, you do your wudu, you do salah, salamu alaykum, you're good. Hada general. Lakin al-ihsan teaches you how to make your salah eligible for acceptance. Not only valid. Technically valid is something, and eligible for acceptance is totally another. Therefore, many people, they may do lots of good deeds. Technically, their deed is valid, but is it accepted? Only Allah knows. There will be lots of people whose deeds are thrown back at their faces in the Day of Judgment. وَالْعَيَاذُ بِاللَّهِ. مَسْأَلْتِ الْقَبُولِ قَبُولِ الْأَعْمَالِ. Therefore, when Allah talks about Maryam عليه السلام, He says, فَتَقَبَّلَهَا رَبُّهَا بِقَبُولٍ. شوف في قبول. If Allah accepts you, then you're okay. لكن if Allah does not accept you, no matter how much you jump up and down, doesn't mean anything. The point is that you have قبول from Allah. So the point is here in this hadith that you don't only focus on Islam and Iman, but you also focus on what? إحسان. You don't focus on making the deed technically valid, but you focus on that, does Allah accept you and your deed, or does Allah reject you and reject your deed? Another dimension to the deed. And it's not about just doing the ritual, it's about doing the spiritual. Yeah? Not ritual, but spiritual. I tried to change that. No more ritual, spiritual. Sheikh Sa'dullah Kayf al-Hal. Good to see you. Sheikh Sa'dullah, old friend. Alhamdulillah. Allah bless him. Always happy to see him. طيب. Very important. Al-Qabul. شوف سيدنا إبراهيم وإسماعيل. What's better than the build? What's the best job? Imagine if Allah counts you with building the Kaaba. Oh. You are right. وعهدنا إلى إبراهيم وإسماعيل أن طهر بيتي للطائفين والعاكفين والركع السجود. وبعدين what happens? وإذ يرفع إبراهيم القواعد من البيت وإسماعيل. Now they're raising the bait. What do they say the first thing once they built the house? Now we, what else do you want? We built, didn't only build the masjid, we built the Kaaba of Allah till the day of judgment. What do they say? Rabbana. Rabbana taqabbal minna. Rabbana taqabbal minna. It's not about building, it's about the qabool. It's not about building. He built the Kaaba. Nowadays you build something and he say, oh, I, mashallah, I gave. Huh? Rabbana taqabbal minna. Taqabbal minna. And if you accept from us, innaka antas sami', begging him, Ya Allah, we build the Kaaba, but Ya Allah, accept from us, innaka antas sami'ul alim. Ibrahim, Ismail, Khalilur Rahman, Ismail al-Dhabih, Anbiya, they're not me and you. It's not your regular average person. No, Khalilur Rahman, Ismail. لكن he says ربنا وإذ يرفع إبراهيم القواعد من البيت وإسماعيل. Now building the house of Allah that will remain till the end of times. How many people will go around the Kaaba and pray there? All their thawab is going to who? إبراهيم وإسماعيل. They erected the house by the will of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. But what do they say at the end? They don't say, now look, what can we do? We have billions of people who will, we will get the rewards. We, whatever we do, no problem. La la, they don't do these things. They say, Rabbana taqabbal min ihsan. Third dimension. Because people leave that third dimension. They focus on making the deed technically valid. Not good enough. Ad-deen is complete. Okay. Let's move on, otherwise we'll be there for a long time. فَتَقَبَّلَهَا رَبُّهَا بِقَبُولٍ حَسَنٍ وَأَنْبَتَهَا نَبَاتًا. يا سلام. كلما دخل. طيب. قال فَأَخْبِرْنِي عَنْ أَمَارَاتِهَا. Tell me about the signs of the day of judgment. He told him that they made will give birth to its master. What does that mean? It means there will be lots of marriages that are not with the wives, with the maids. And that man who will marry the maids will have children from them. And as that child, because she or he is the child of the master, the master, the maid will give birth to her master. Happens nowadays? Happens. More than that. As the mother, تلد الأمة ربتها, the mother gives birth to her master. We can take the hadith in this way as well. What does that mean, mother gives birth to its master? Because it's an indication of how rotten the times will be. So that the children act like they're the masters of their parents. The mother gives birth to its master. Now the father is fearful of speaking to his son because his son acts like his master. And the daughter acts like she's the master of her mother. Indication of the last times, the day of judgment. أمارات الساعة. قال فأخبرني عن أماراتها. Tell me about the signs of the day of judgment. He told him this. When things will be reversed. And you see it nowadays in the akhlaq of the people. The children, they act like they're the masters of their parents. Not the other way around. Hadith Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We take from this hadith before, what time is the finishing? 6:09. We take from this hadith also the adab of seeking knowledge. Sayyidina Jibreel alayhi salam came with adab to seek the knowledge of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to show us how we seek knowledge. So how did he seek knowledge? He came with adab. He taught us how to do these things. also the prophetic method of teaching. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not tell them, you ignorant people, let me teach you what Islam and Iman and Ihsan means. Oh, you people don't know? Jahils? Because nowadays we learn a couple of words and we think we know everything and everybody else doesn't know anything. And a method like the... some other time we'll talk about that. We're fasting, alhamdulillah. Allah. Lakin Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam did not make people feel less. It's easy to make anyone feel stupid. Everyone knows something other people don't know. You know something I don't know, I know something you don't know, I know something you don't know. That's not the success. That's not leadership. Leadership is not to make those who don't know feel stupid. But leadership is to make those who don't know love what you know and come to learn it. Not to make distance between you and the people. That any fool can make a distance between himself and the people. Lakin, it is not to make a distance. So therefore, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Jibreel come to teach us. How do they teach us? In a third way example. Ya Rasulullah, what is Islam? So who to listen? Jibreel doesn't know, he knows. Lakin who is he trying to teach? Sahaba radiallahu ta'ala anhum. So that they learn in a way that is nice and that is good and they don't feel distant from Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. I finished with an example. Imam al-Hasan and al-Husayn, they were young boys. They saw an old man making wudu. You probably know the story. I'm not telling you anything new. How do we tell? They're young boys. This is an older man. How can we tell him? So they went to the man and they said, oh uncle, oh old man, come, we want you to be the judge between me and my brother, Al-Hasan and Al-Husayn, to see who amongst us does wudu better according to the sunnah of our grandfather. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So Al-Hasan started, Al-Husayn started, and they're making wudu, explaining how their grandfather sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was doing wudu. And then the man realized, he said, look, let me tell you something. Both of you know how to do wudu. I'm the one who doesn't know how to do wudu. Al-ilm, ya ahibba, knowledge doesn't make people distant from others. It makes people within others. Now, Sayyidina Ali Dharar, when he described him, he says, kana fina, among the most beloved things to me, yani, and the characteristics of Sayyidina Ali and all the Sahaba of Allah alayhim, he says, kana fina ka ahadina. Ali was amongst us like one of us. Yani, you didn't feel he was any different. فَإِذَا تَكَلَّمْ until he talks. Once he talks, فَعَنْ مِثْلِ لُؤْلُؤِ الْمَنْظُومِ then the pearls come out. Until he doesn't talk, you feel him. He's like one of us. كَلَمْ فِينَا كَأَحَدِنَا يعني, you don't know who Ali is, you think everyone, no problem, he's one of us. You don't know who Ali is. Until he talks. Therefore he says, Sayyidina Ali, رضي الله عنه كما he says, المرء مخبوء تحت لسانه متى تكلم عرف. He says, the human being is hidden behind his tongue. The caliber of the human being is hidden behind his tongue. Once he talks, you know his caliber. So Darar says, كان فينا كأحدنا يجيبنا إذا سألنا. If we ask him, he answers to us. وَيُلَبِّينَا إِذَا دَعَوْنَا فَإِذَا تَكَلَّمْ until he talks. فَإِذَا تَكَلَّمْ يَا سَلَامْ take now, open. The city of knowledge. The gates of the city of knowledge opens. And this is how it is. And therefore the teaching, العلم يرفع بيوتا لا عماد لها والجهل يهدم بيوت العز والكرم. العلم makes people, the more you know, the more humble you are. Huh? The less you know, the more arrogant you are, all the time. And therefore you see, سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين صلى الله تعالى عليه وآله وسلم, الله tells him, واخفض جناحك للمؤمنين. اخفض جناحك للمؤمنين. هو سيد الأنبياء وهو على خلق عظيم. He lowers his wings to the believers. نعم. وهكذا كان الصحابة رضي الله عنهم أجمعين. This was الصحابة أبو بكر وعمر وعثمان. May Allah be pleased with them all. You see Sayyidina al-Siddiq رضي الله عنه stands on the minbar the day he was appointed, elected by votes. The majority of Muslims or the Sahaba voted for him as the Khalifa, as the first righteous Khalifa. He stands and says, وَلِّيْتُ عَلَيْكُمْ وَلَسْتُ بِأَفْضَلِكُمْ. I became the leader upon you, I'm not the best of you. What kind of humility is that to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? هذه مدرسة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. سيدنا عمر becomes the Khalifa. Khalifa, ruling everything. What does he say? He sees Bilal al-Habashi. Bilal is a slave. Excuse me, no one is a slave. All of us are slaves of Allah. But they considered him a slave. He looks at Bilal and says, Bilal Umar, in his Khilafah, Bilal Sayyiduna. Umar is Qurashi. Bani Adi, Quraysh. Second righteous Khalifa, not any, you know. Lakin he says, Bilal is our master. Bilal Sayyiduna. Not only that, وَأَعْتَقَهُ سَيِّدُنَا. And the one who freed him is our master. You figure out who freed Bilal. نَزَعَ اللَّهُ مَا فِي قُلُوبِهِمْ. ناس طهرهم الله. Allah purified these people. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for me and you to realize these things so we can take the benefits from the ahadith. وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد وآله. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين, وأفضل الصلاة وأكمل التسليم على سيدنا ومولانا وحبيبنا وشفيعنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا